Cheers.
Cheers.
Welcome to Almost Rich, Almost Famous in These Streets.
This is our holiday edition episode. I feel like I'm in the North Pole, but actually I'm at Society Lounge in their pop-up bar, only here during the holidays. It's Miracle on 4th. And we've got some fancy cocktails, too.
I mean,
how cute are these?
These are very fancy. So beforehand, before we started filming, she came over and poured a little powdered sugar, so it was snowing. It was the cutest thing ever.
Here it is. Okay. Yippee-ki-yay, motherfucker.
Here comes Santa Claus, here comes Santa Claus, right down Santa Claus Lane. Mixing and mixing and all his reindeers pulling on the rain.
Ooh.
Okay.
Oh my God, that is so good.
Okay, so it's rum, a lot of rum, coconut, and pineapple juice.
Oh, that is so good. Hold on, one more little sip.
Okay, one more sip. While you do that one, I'm going to do the Santa Rex, which is Blanco tequila, mezcal, almond, lime, and tiki bitters.
I feel like you'll like that. You like tequila.
I do.
Do you like mezcal, though?
No, but we're going to give it a go.
Okay. Let's see what you think.
Oh, my God. It's very, like, Christmas in a glass.
See, mine, I feel like it's, like, Christmas on a beach.
Ooh, I love Christmas.
Yeah, I feel like I'm at Christmas on a beach.
Okay, great. Now. And then, lastly, we have the Christmapolitan. I feel like you do this one.
To just kind of enjoy this for a moment.
You need to pass it along. Like, I would have drank too.
No, I don't know where to
share. So Bridget was going to try to drink the whole drink before we moved on, so we need to chime in.
Oh,
that's...
I'm trying to guess what's in it before I look at what's actually in it. I feel like there's a hint of cinnamon. Am I right?
You're actually wrong.
Okay. You know, I've never been
100% wrong. Actually,
no, I'm really good at drinking alcohol. I'm not really good at guessing what kind of liquor is actually in it.
Vodka, elderflower, dry vermouth, spiced cranberry sauce, lime, rosemary, and absinthe mist. Don't even ever try to tell me that the spiced cranberry is cinnamon because it's
not. Yeah, I think it is.
All right, well, my favorite of all of the drinks that were brought to us today, and we will keep trying these, by the way, but we got the naughty and nice shots.
And I just felt like I deserved the nice shot. Because I'm a good girl all year long. Betsy? I don't know. The naughty girl.
All right, bottoms up.
Should we just do them together?
Yeah. This is gingerbread spiced rye.
I don't even know what that means.
I don't either. Cheers.
Well, what's the thing? Naughty, nice, everything nice? No.
Never heard that one.
Okay, well, we didn't even cheers, but okay, bye.
I am really obsessed with this one.
I'm not mad about it because I actually like Nice Santa Rex.
Yeah.
It's not my typical go-to drink, but I'm just having myself a time. I just feel like I'm like a drunk elf in the North Pole.
Speaking of being a drunk elf in the North Pole, those are really fancy socks. Where'd you get those?
You know, I actually felt like I was like wearing just like a cute tame outfit today. I'm like, all right, we're like doing a holiday episode. I'll just like wear a few items. I mean, if I knew I was walking into here, I'd have like put on my Santa dress. I'd have put on my hat. I would have put on like my Christmas lights around me.
Mm-hmm.
So you think this is like not cute?
Yeah. Well, I think it just goes to show that there are two different types of people in this world. Ones who love an ugly Christmas sweater party.
Wait, this is not an ugly Christmas sweater. This is like cute. Rob, isn't this cute?
Well, I think you look nice. I am not big into ugly Christmas sweater parties, as you know. I can't imagine why anyone would choose to look ugly.
But see, I'm not trying to look ugly. I thought I looked cute. Like, I thought this was, I saw this sweater and was like, oh, that's a really cute Christmas sweater. I'm going to get it to wear to my next holiday Christmas party and maybe our holiday episode. And you thought I wore an ugly Christmas sweater? Oh, my God.
Well, I thought you did your makeup nice today.
I put on my red lipstick, yep. Missing my earrings.
I know. I was a little shocked you didn't wear those like light bulb earrings that teachers wear.
Well, I have them. I know. They light up.
Oh, you do?
Yes. Oh. And I just didn't have them at my place. And I'm very upset about it. So that's why I'm like, you know what, Bridget? It's fine. You're not going to wear all of your typical holiday outfit today. You're just going to be very tame. The fact that you think I'm a lot right now is pretty wild.
Well, you're
just wearing yellow.
Well, this is actually gold, which is very holiday. I also happen to have red nails.
Okay.
And I'm wearing green boots.
What? She literally has socks that match her drink. Betsy, that is not the holiday spirit.
Come Santa Claus, here comes Santa Claus, right down Santa Claus Lane. He's got a bag that's filled with toys for boys and girls again. Hear those sleigh bells jingle, jangle, oh, what a beautiful sight. So jump in there.
Like, he's not actually the Grinch. Like, I feel like you do kind of like the holidays a little bit, even though you're wearing socks that say motherfucker on them and you're not wearing anything holiday-ish. What is your favorite part of the holidays?
I actually have a lot of favorite parts of the holidays. I love Christmas carols. I love Christmas movies. I actually get very into the spirit. I especially love those random holiday texts.
Always from the people from your past.
You know, that Merry Christmas. Hope everything's been well.
Tell the family I said hello. How is everyone doing?
I miss seeing all of you guys. Tell your sisters hi.
What are your plans for New Year's? I'm going to be in town. Don't know, I haven't seen you in 2 years.
I haven't wanted to reach out, don't care that you're in town. I get, my favorite one is, I have this one specific person who reaches out, literally, I haven't seen them since 2000, reaches out to me every single year. Hey, I'll be in Cleveland this holiday season. Are you around?
Yep, I live here, always here.
I'm around, but not to ever see you again.
You know, it never actually makes sense to me. Like, people are in your past for a reason, but then they love to use the holidays as an excuse to get back in. Like, no, the holidays are supposed to be about cheerfulness, being around people you love, your family. And these assholes always try to come ruin it.
What's your favorite part of the holiday?
Well, definitely not that. That's probably my least favorite part.
I know.
When you, but okay, I will say, see, this is where I contradict myself. So I get annoyed when people like to reach out from the past. But then the ones that I expect every year, when they don't, I'm like, well, what? You've been reached out for the past 5 years, and this is the year you decide you're not going to say Merry Christmas? What? Did you find someone new to stalk? I don't know. So, like, I kind of, like, I hate them, but I actually like them at the same time. I don't know. I really like to get dressed up. Again, it's my team outfit.
It has balls on it.
And it's a cute sweater, not an ugly sweater.
Wait, hold on. I actually have a question. When you purchased this, were you, like, oh, this is so cool. It looks like Rudolph's nose. Or were you like, oh my God, they look like Christmas light bulbs? Like, is that the idea?
I saw it and I said, oh my gosh, what a cute little cardigan. I'm going to look like a Christmas tree. I'm already tall. I got the green on with all the bulbs. I thought it was going to be a huge hit. I couldn't wait for you to see me today. And then when you were like, oh, I didn't know this is a Christmas, ugly Christmas sweater party over here. I'm like, and here I thought it looked so freaking cute. So I like that, but I also like to sing Christmas carols, even though I'm not that good of a singer.
Oh, did you want to perform one? I don't, why would I even ask? I know you want to perform.
You know, it's actually a newer one.
Oh, okay.
It's a little rap by Justin Bieber.
Okay.
Rom pa pa pom, rom pa 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 pom pom. Yeah, I'm on the drum. Yeah, I'm on the sand drum. Yeah. You see, now I forget the rest.
Thank God.
I'm surprised you didn't hear this in the Bible. I know that's one part of it. I don't know. I'm getting drunk. Bye.
This is just such a lovely holiday ARAF intimate moment together.
We're on Miracle on 4th. I got my Christmapolitan. Don't get it confused with the Cosmopolitan because it's not. I feel like we're like a little couple right now.
I know, me too. This is so lovely. I'm having such a nice date.
Well, I'm happy you feel that way because I feel like a lot of times I like force you to actually go on dates with me and you're like, listen, I already have someone. So the fact that you're enjoying this with me is, really means a lot.
Are you expecting like a really fancy gift from me this year?
No, I just really like your time.
Well, I got you a gift, actually.
You did?
Yeah, I did. It's not the ring you wanted from Bookman & Son Fine Jewelers.
Betsy, if you got me the ring from Bookman & Son Fine Jewelers, I would have died.
I didn't. I didn't. I definitely didn't.
Well, unfortunately, I don't have like an actual significant other in my life, but I am dying for this ring. It's diamonds and gold. It like crisscrosses. It fits perfectly on my middle finger. I want it so bad. Santa? There's still time. I've been a good girl.
I actually am going a totally separate route. Like, shockingly, I'm going a very different route with gift giving this year. I'm doing necessities. I'm buying people things that they need.
Like practical things.
Like practical things. Like, for example, my sister shaves her face. And so I got her this lovely tool that, like, it's like a electric razor. It's necessary.
What sister? I feel like none of your sisters have like beards or mustaches.
Bridget, it's not about beards or mustaches. Like, we all have a little peach fuzz that we need to get rid of.
Yeah, I don't think I need that. Maybe you're looking at me and thinking, let's put it this way, I would not use it, okay?
So what kind of gift giver are you? Are you a practical gift giver? Do you like to give people things that they never buy for themselves?
Like, I like to give experiences.
Oh,
so
yeah.
So for instance, like really the only gifts I have to give are for my family. And rather than like buying them like a coffee maker mm-hmm. or like something that they need, I'm like, I'm going to take you out to a nice dinner. I'm going to get you like a gift card, but like, sorry, I'm coming.
Oh, I wish you'd get that for me, then I can order whatever I want. Do you want to do that with me for the holidays?
Wait, so like you want me to get you a gift card, but I can't come?
So I could take my tall drink of water.
Me or the other one?
Both. I'd love to take you both. We have a great throuple. So you're not looking for somebody to cozy up with this year other than me?
No. The holidays are always so interesting because I feel like people get pressured and they feel like they have to be dating someone. And so like come like November, around like Thanksgiving time, people try to rekindle with old flames.
Ugh.
During that time, like, okay, let's just get together so I have someone to spend the holidays with, so I have someone to spend New Year's Eve with.
Yep.
I'm not into it.
I think it has everything to do with getting gifts. I think people go through this season and they pretend it's because they want to cuddle, but they really just want a nice holiday gift.
I never thought about it like that.
Yeah.
That's not me. I'm like not into gifts. Again, I'd rather you take me to an experience than do that.
Well, I got you a gift, but it will be an experience as well.
Well, you could just take me back to Miracle on 4th before the holidays are over. And just really have a rager here. I want all the naughty and nice shots. I want to get yippee-ki-yay motherfuckers all night.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Maybe some more Crispapolitans.
All right. Well, we'll definitely do that.
You know, I will say during the holidays, I typically drink a lot throughout the year, but during the holidays, I drink a lot more.
Yeah.
Thank goodness I have my new go-to spot during the holidays. Typically, it's the Society Lounge, which is on East 4th Street in downtown Cleveland. But during the holidays, it's Miracle on 4th. This is certainly a little miracle on 4th Street. It is open through New Year's Day, so make sure you get here with all of your friends. Try all the phenomenal cocktails. I'm a little tipsy myself.
I know you are. Make sure you check them out at Society Lounge on 4th on Instagram.
Cheers.